Okay, after the entering governing council details under part 1, okay, there are 4 criteria under part 1, then we go for the part 2. First criteria under part 2, that is land and building details. Second criteria, that is program intake, then classroom and seminar area, then area details. Then we go for the first criteria under part 2, that is land and building details of the college. Okay, under this criteria, there are two important aspects. One is land details available in the college, another one is the building details available in college. Okay, the first one is location of the land. If it is a rural or urban or any other place, we want to select these aspects. Then land ownership details, there are 5 important land ownership details are available in this menu. Okay, that is, if it is a college got the land by the gift deed or government lease or registered sale deed or purchased land under this one. Okay, lease or registered lease or government land. Okay, if it is a government college, we want to select the government land, or the private person gifted land to the government. Okay, we go for the gift deed. Gift deed. Okay, there are 2 types of or 3 types. Each one we want to enter. Okay, if it is college having 3 types of the land ownership in their college. Okay, we want to enter each type of the land details. Okay, I selecting gift deed. Okay, that is urban. Okay, total acres. Total area under gift deed we got land. Okay, land registered in the name of which one, then registration date, registration number, then survey number. If it is a rural, that is survey number will available, or if it is a land located in urban area, we will get the PID, that is property identification number, we want to enter here. Okay, if it is that land conversion was done, land use certificate issued by the, that is deputy commissioner of the district. Okay, what about the land use certificate date? Then if it is a land mortgaged, yes or no. Okay, these are the important land details. Okay, then we go for the if it is a college having government land. Okay, here is total number of area under government land. Land registered in the name of which one, then land registration date, then go for the land registration number, survey number or PID number, then if it is converted land, that is land use certificate issued by the deputy commissioner of the district, land use certificate date, then mortgage land, yes or no. Okay, this is the part 1, that is land details available for the college. Okay, then go for the save. Okay, each one after the entering the details, go for the save, then we will get the information here, records will available here. Okay, then go for the building details. Under building details, first one is building status. There are 2 important aspects in the building status. One is construction completed or under construction. Okay, if it is college having constructed building already, that building utilizing the college, then we want to already under construction process is going, then you go for the under construction. Okay, there are 2 important aspects. Already college have 20 rooms, that is completed construction, go for the completed construction. Then you go you enter the total built up area under this one. Okay, total built up area ready. Then total instructional area, that is classrooms, seminar halls, laboratories and library, in square meters we want to enter here. Total area reserved for the or using for the classrooms, seminar halls, laboratories and library. Okay, here it is the second important aspect in constructed completed building, that is total administrative area. That area using for the office purpose, administrative office purpose, the principal chamber, for both one in square meters we want to enter, then go for the save. Okay, after that, if it is a under construction building you have in your college, go for the under construction. This is second aspect. Okay, total built up area under construction, how much area ready under this component, then this component under construction building, if it is that construction having two important aspects, that is classrooms as well as the office, you want to enter. Otherwise leave here zero, you put zero. Okay, here you want to enter how much area under construction for the classroom, seminar halls and laboratories and library in square meters. Then go for the save button. Okay, these are the two important parts under land and building details available in the college.